Listen, you do not need 51,000 different email addresses just to run your business, okay? You don't need to have multiple different paid G Suite business addresses in case you want different employees to have their own email addresses, different programs, or different departments. In today's video, I'm going to tell you how you can turn one G Suite business email address into up to 30. What up, Kingdom Builders? Welcome back to my channel. I am Ebony Evaughn, your favorite business consultant in these internet streets. Welcome to Soul Struck Land. This is my internet home where I teach you how to go from confused to the ethical cash generating boss that you are meant to be. Welcome back to another episode of Ebony Explains. Today, I am talking about how you can turn one business G Suite email address into 30, okay? So one thing that comes up a lot in my coaching sessions or on Q&A sessions with my clients is like, how much are you paying for all these email addresses, right? And so I'm like, I only have two paid for email addresses. I have one that is personal to me, and then I have like a general one that is like a customer support box. But within that general support box, I've kind of created additional aliases so that different questions or different kind of inquiries go to the appropriate funnel, right? And so people think that I literally have like 10 or like 20 different business email addresses from G Suite, but I don't. I literally only have two. One of them is for emails that go to me, and then the other email address goes to the respective boxes, but it's technically all going to the same place. They're just annotated differently, okay? So basically what I mean is, let's say that you have a business enterprise and you want to have, let's say, an email address for billing. So all of your billing will go to the billing email address. You also want to have another email address maybe for customer support, right? And so that will have a different email address. Maybe you also do like partnerships or sponsorships, and so you want to have a separate email address for that as well. But they all pretty much go to the same customer support or information box or email address. So in order for you to create an email address for billing and customer support and for partnerships, you can have all of those go to the same inbox but use separate email addresses. And so that is what I want to show you how to do in this video, but it's easier for me to just show you on my computer and walk you through the process of how you do this, and then afterwards we'll come back and talk about some benefits and best case scenarios. And voila, just like that, I have teleported myself into the laptop, and I want to show you how you can actually set up your aliases and turn one email into up to 30, okay? So right now I am inside my admin console for my Google account, and to get to this location, all you have to do is go to directory and then users, and when you click on users, it will list all the users that have active accounts within your business G Suite setup, okay? So at the moment, you can see I only have two active accounts. So my actual support aliases are all under this customer support email address. So I'm going to not use that one. I'm going to use my personal email because I'm going to set it up from scratch so you can understand how to do this for yourself without it already being A-listed set up. So to get started, all you have to do is just click on the account that you want to add the email addresses for. And then from here, what you want to do is go to add alternate emails. And once you click on this, you can see that it is absolutely blank over here. It says alternate email addresses. And so all you have to do is just start typing the prefixes for the emails that you want to add. So for example, what I want to add here is customer service
at socialshookrep.com, right? And then from there, I would just go to the next one. Let's say I want to have an email address for sponsors to send their notifications or requests to. You can, I don't need that at. So you could say sponsors. And then in addition to that, maybe you want to have like a general inquiry box. You could say inquiry at yourdomain.com. And let's say you're going to be hiring, like myself. My VA recently, well, I don't want to say she got a new job, but she's changing what she does. So she's no longer just going to be a VA. She has kind of expanded her services to being an online business manager. So she's going to be moving on to other opportunities, and I'm very happy for her. But I'm going to have to hire a new VA soon, right? So I may want to have an email that says jobs, so all the applications can go to that email address. And maybe, let's see, what else? Maybe you want all of your media requests or media inquiries to go to a specific email address. So you can create your aliases that way, and you can add up to 30 different aliases in here, okay? And then once you add all the aliases that you want, all you have to do is just hit save. I'm not going to hit save because I don't actually want to save these. Once you hit save, you will get a notice that says these aliases have been saved. I'm not going to actually save these because, number one, I don't need these. I already have different aliases set up. And then, number two, I don't want y'all spamming me in these email addresses, okay? I know how y'all be doing sometimes with the spam, the cold emails. But listen, so once you hit save, it will save. It will confirm that you have saved your email aliases. And then it will also give you a notice that most likely will tell you that it will take up to like 24 hours, sometimes 48 hours for your email addresses to be available. But once you save these, you can actually go test it out by just sending an email and seeing if it goes through or not. All right.
Welcome back. Hopefully now you are crystal clear on how you can actually create up to 30 email aliases for just one G Suite business email address. So you may be wondering why you would even want to do this in the first place, and actually doing this does have several benefits. So the first obvious reason that you may want to have different email aliases is going to be for organization. And so this is the primary reason why I actually use this in my business, is because it helps me to direct clients to the right place. And then it also helps me with prioritizing how we respond to different inquiries. So for example, we have a specific email address that is for paid customers that are inside of our VIP sessions and our high ticket offers. So my accelerator, for other specific like hands-on coaching programs. And so those people have a different support box than just people who maybe purchase regular low ticket digital products or courses. That's more so general support. And then we have one that is for external potential clients or just external inquiries that are not customers. So each one of those, even though they're all basically customer support related, we have different priority statuses that we assign to them. Obviously, when it comes to our VIP clients, high ticket clients, we want to make sure that we're on top of everything, we're being responsive, and we're communicating in a timely fashion versus someone who is just sending a general inquiry to ask a question about maybe potentially buying a product or service, right? Or maybe having me come and speak at an event or something like that. So it helps me to organize and prioritize customer service stuff. In addition to that, it also helps with branding. So having different email addresses that have their specific purposes reinforces our brand identity, as well as just professionalism and making sure that the right people get to the right place at the right time so that we can respond to them accordingly. And last but not least, another benefit of actually having multiple different business email addresses is for efficiency. So because of the way my business is structured, it helps us with being more efficient and streamlined. So I'm currently looking for a new assistant, but when I had an assistant, basically based on the email address, she would know, okay, if this is something that I need to send to Ebony, I need to forward this to her so that she can take care of this. Or if it's like, oh, this is customer support, this is general in nature, this is something that I can take care of, right? And so by having those different processes, it really helps to streamline the back end of the business so that everything runs more efficiently. All right, let me know down in the comments below this video if you found it helpful in creating additional business email addresses for your G Suite account. Again, the whole purpose of creating these aliases are so helpfully you can reinforce the efficiency, your brand identity, as well as organization in your business. So the last thing that I want to say about using these emails to be more efficient and for organization purposes is, let's say you actually have employees that have their own personal email address. So let's say you have amy@yourdomain.com and you have these aliases in your support box. You have like an info, you have a hello, you have a billing, you have tech support or whatever. And let's say that Amy is over your IT department, so you want all of the tech emails to go to her. You can actually set up your alias so that that tech support email that's an alias will actually go to Amy's inbox. And then for any reason, if she quits or she's terminated, then you still will have those in your default box as well. Or you can go in and then redirect them to another person. So let me know if you want to see a tutorial on how you can actually redirect your email aliases to a particular employee box or to a particular email address. Otherwise, I want to say thanks so much for stopping by my internet home. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and turn on those notifications so you will be the first one to get notified anytime I upload another video just like this. All right, bye y'all.